In our passage today, we are presented with a stark contrast between Christ and the things of this world.
今天的经文，我们要来凸显的是基督与世界当中所产生的一个强烈的对比。
Paul shows us the central conflict between the beliefs and promises held out by the powers of this age and the true faith and its promises found in the Son of God.
保罗在此向我们揭示了这个时代的力量所持有的这个信仰和应许之间的一个核心的冲突。
In Christ, we find the fulfillment of all we need.
在基督里面，我们可以找到我们所需要的一切。
In him, we find forgiveness and holiness, while the world leads only to guilt, condemnation, and humiliation. In this text, we are presented with the riches of Christ and the fullness of his grace.
所以我们现在就从这段经文中来看见基督的丰盛。
Since we haven't been working through the book of Colossians here in previous weeks, I would like to spend a little bit of time to explain some of the background and basic content of this book.
由于之前我们还没有读完哥罗西书这本书, 所以我想花点时间来解释这本书的一些背景和基本的内容。
Colossians, of course, was written by the Apostle Paul to a rather young congregation in the city of Colossae, which, if you were to look on a map, would be found in the southwestern part of modern-day Turkey, about 100 miles inland.
哥罗西书是由保罗写给哥罗西城里面一个年轻的教会。 如果你看地图的话，你会发现哥罗西城位于现代土耳其南部，大约在100英里的内陆地区。
Paul did not plant this church, but instead we read in chapter 1, verse 7, that the gospel was brought to them by Epaphras.
保罗并没有建立这个教会，但我们在1章7节中有读到，福音是由以巴弗带给他们的。
This letter can be broadly reduced down to two main points.
这封书信大约可以归纳于两个要点。
First, Paul is reiterating the gospel that had been given to them. And second, Paul is providing warnings about false teachings that might cause them to stray away from this gospel.
Okay, 首先保罗重申他所教导的福音，其次就是可能导致他们偏离这个福音的错误来提出警告。
This chapter is where Paul lays out his gospel at length. He reminds them that God has transferred them from the domain of darkness to the kingdom of his beloved Son.
第一章是阐述的保罗他福音的地方，在这里保罗提醒他们，上帝将他们从黑暗的领域带出来。
He tells us how those who believe in Christ have received the forgiveness of sins.
他告诉我们那些相信基督的人是如何得到赦免。
He elaborates more fully on this redemption by speaking of who Christ is.
他在这里阐述了救赎是透过传讲耶稣是谁。
We don't have time to discuss it at length here, but in chapter 1, verses 15 through 20, he clearly lays out the deity of Christ.
我们现在没有很多的时间来详细的讲述，但是他在一章15到20节中清楚地阐述了基督的神性。
Christ is God incarnate, by whom all things are made, by whom all things hold together. And by whom all things are being redeemed.
基督是道成肉身的神，万有都是靠着他造的，万有都是靠着他维系的，万有都是靠着他来救赎的。
He is preeminent above all.
他是在万有之上。
This same Christ has taken on a body in which he bore our sins so that we might be holy and blameless if we have faith in him.
同样的，这位基督取了肉身，为了担当我们的罪孽，这样如果我们对他有信心，我们就可以成为圣洁和无可指责的人。
In our text this morning, he begins to shift to warnings about departing from Christ.
在今天的经文当中呢，他开始将这个将经文转移到对于离开基督的一个警告。
This is a common pattern of going from doctrine to ethics, which is common in Paul's letters.
这种从教育转向伦理的模式，在保罗的书信中是非常见到的。
He often begins by explaining the gospel, that is, what Christ has done for us. Then he moves to speak about how we ought to live in light of this good news.
他经常先解释福音，也就是基督为我们所做的事情，然后他才开始谈论我们应该如何根据这个福音来生活。
It's important to understand this because the commands of God are given to us in the context of our salvation.
这一点是非常重要的，因为上帝的命令是要我们在得到救赎的这个前提下赐给我们的。
To obey God, to seek after His will in all we do is a direct outgrowth of what He has done for us.
所以顺服上帝在我们所要做的一切事上寻求他的旨意，这是主为我们所做的事情一个很直接的结果。
Our works do not cause this salvation, but instead show evidence of it.
我们的好行为呢，并不导致拯救，并不导致我们得到救赎，而是彰显了我们得到救赎的凭据。
This is why Paul uses the language of fruit when he talks about good works. And this is the same analogy that Jesus used in his own public ministry when he said, a tree is known by its fruits.
Okay. 这就是为什么保罗在谈论善行的时候使用果子来做比喻。这跟耶稣在他自己的事工中用同样的类比，说凭着果子就可以认出这棵树来。
Scripture tells us that the kind of people we are is evidenced by the things that we do.
所以圣经告诉我们，人是怎样从我们所做的事情就可以看得出来。
So it is Paul's hope here that we would accept this gospel and trust in Christ.So that we might then be able to grow in knowledge, patience, and endurance.
因此，保罗在这里希望我们可以接受福音，并靠着基督，好让我们在知识、忍耐和恒久上成长。
With these introductory comments in mind, we may now turn to verse 6 in chapter 2, and we read where Paul says, "Therefore, as you received Christ Jesus the Lord,So walk in him. We understand that he means that we have received the forgiveness of sins through faith in Christ. And now, in this new relationship, we are to bear fruits or to perform good works that are in keeping with this new life.
请记住这些介绍性的评论。我们现在一起翻到第二章第六节。当我们读到保罗说，你们既然接受了主耶稣基督，就当遵他而信。我们明白他的意思是我们已经接受了上帝的赦免，也只有在这种新的关系中，我们要结出果实，或做出与新生活一致的善行。
These good works are possible only if we are in fact rooted and built up and established in the faith.
当我们确实在他里面内心坚固时，这些善行才有可能实现。
So here Paul is giving a very short summary of what he has said already in chapter 1. And he does this in order to transition us into what will be our focus this morning, which begins in verse 8.
所以保罗在这里已经 就已经说过的内容做一个非常简短的总结。他这样做是为了过渡到今天我们早上从第八节开始的一个焦点。
Before we move there, I simply want to note that while good works are very much evidence of us being changed inwardly, this is not a passive thing.
在我们到那里之前呢，我只想指出，虽然善行这件事情在很大的程度上证明我们内在的改变，但这并不是一个被动的事件。
Rather, it is something that we take up actively, that we strive for, that we have to endure in.
相反的，它是我们积极的行动、努力的争取以及恒久忍耐的事情。
God has given us all we need to do this, so there is no cause for fear. But He has remade us for good works, not simply to live as we did before.
所以上帝在这些事情上已经给我们所需要的一切，所以我们没有理由惧怕，因为主已重塑了我们，让我们可以来行善。
Turning now to verse 8, we read, "See to it that no one takes you captive by philosophy and empty deceit, according to human tradition, according to the elemental spirits of the world, and not according to Christ."
好，我们现在翻到第八节，这里我们讲到，你们要谨慎，恐怕有人用他的学理和虚空的妄言，不照着基督，乃照人间的遗传和世间的小学，把你们掳去。
This passage sets up a basic dichotomy between the world and everything that it has to offer and Christ.
这段经文是将世界所能给的一切与基督之间建立了一个基本的二分法。
And this dichotomy is fundamental to Paul's message.
这个二分法呢，也是在这里是在这里是保罗要传达的一个信息的基础。
Now, before we see Paul's reasoning for this strict opposition, let's make sure we understand clearly what he is not saying here.
在我们了解保罗的推测之前，我们先清楚地了解他在这里没有说的内容。
Paul is not saying that all philosophy is bad.
保罗并不是说所有的哲学都是不好的。
If we read closely here, he is particularly condemning any philosophy which is contrary to Christ.
如果我们仔细阅读这经文的话，我们发现保罗是特别的在谴责任何与基督相左的观念的这种哲学。
We can see this from the fact that he is talking about being taken captive by philosophies which are according to human tradition and by what he calls the elemental spirits of the world.
在这里我们可以看出他所说的人间的遗传和世上的小学就把你们掳去这句话来看得出来。
That word according here tells us that rather than a blanket condemnation of all philosophy, he has his sights aimed on the philosophies or religious systems that are grounded in things other than Christ, in things other than the truth.
Okay, 这里按照这个字，是在告诉我们，他并不是全盘的反对所有的哲学，而是那些，跟质疑基督的真，而是他在质疑基督真理之外的哲学或宗教的体系。
This is not a condemnation of the discipline of philosophy, which has always been invaluable to Christian theology, but a condemnation of these philosophies that are opposed to the Christian faith in some way or another.
这不是在谴责，对哲学的谴责，而是，哲学对于基督教来说，哲学是对于基督教是一无是处的，而是说那些以某种方式反对基督教信仰的错误思想的拒绝。
This is a rejection of false philosophy.
这是对错误的哲学提出的一个拒绝。
A short word about the phrase "elemental spirits of the world."
关于世上的小学这件事。
We simply don't know what exactly he is referring to here, but if you look at the next section of this chapter in verse 20, you will see that what he is talking about here probably has to do with worldly religious practices or customs which God has neither commanded nor allowed his people to use.
在这里我们没有办法看出他指的是什么，但是如果我们看一下第二十节那个地方，你就会发现到他这里所指的可能是与上帝所禁止的世俗宗教或者是民俗有关的事情。
Paul's reason for rejecting these various approaches to religion is quite simple. The reason we ought to prefer Christ over and against everything that the world has to offer is simply because in him, that is in Christ,The whole fullness of deity dwells bodily, and you have been filled in him who is the head and rule, the head of all rule and authority.
保罗拒绝世俗的理由非常的简单，在这里我们应该可以选择基督，或者是选择基督胜过世界所能提供的一切，因为在他里面，在他里面那是。在基督里面，神性的一切的丰盛和有形有体的居住在基督里面，你们也被充满了，因为他是一切统治的元首。
We should prefer Christ over the world because Christ is God.
所以我们应该我们应该爱基督胜过于世界，因为基督就是神。
Because Christ is preeminent and because he fills us with all life.
因为基督是至高无上的，因为他用一切，来充满我们。
Therefore, we cannot possibly go anywhere else for these things.
所以我们没有办法，在其他地方找到这些。
Because God himself is truth, goodness, and life. To go anywhere else is simply to seek after lies, evil, and death.
因为上帝是真理、良善和生命，在其他的地方只能找得到的是谎言、邪恶跟死亡。
The opposition here is absolute because Christ is absolute.
所以，在这里反对是绝对的，因为基督就是绝对的。
Christ is the fullness of truth, and he leaves no room for anything that is false.
基督是完全的真理，他不给任何的虚假留下余地。
To have Christ by faith is to be in utter opposition to anything that claims to have a different truth or a different way to God.
凭着信心得着基督，就是反对任何声称有不同的真理，或者是不同的通往神的道路的事物。
But Paul does not simply leave us with this broad, almost theoretical opposition between Christ and the things of this world.
保罗不仅仅给我们留下了基督与世界之间理论上的对立。
Most of this text is an explanation of what this fullness of Christ means to us in practical terms.
所以，本段经文大部分的内容是在对基督里的丰盛意味的是什么来做解释。
The first practical reality of this fullness of Christ can be seen in the significance of our baptism.
所以基督的丰盛的一个第一个事实是可以从我们洗礼的意义上来看出。
Baptism is a sign and seal of what Moses promised the people of God in Deuteronomy 30 verse 6 when he said, The Lord your God...will circumcise your hearts and the hearts of your descendants so that you may love him with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your life.
洗礼的洗礼是摩西在生命记二十章对不起生命记三十章第六节中向上帝的百姓应许向上帝的百姓应许的这个记号和印记。当时他说耶和华你的神必将你心里必将 你和你的后裔心里的污秽除掉，好叫你可以尽心尽性 爱耶和华你的神，使你可以存活。
Baptism reminds us that we who believe have been circumcised with a circumcision made without hands.
洗礼提醒了我们，这些相信受了非人手的割礼的人。
That this regeneration of our hearts, this renewal of our inward man, is a work of the Holy Spirit.
所以使我们的内心重生，我们内在更新，这是圣灵的工作。
When Paul talks here about putting off the body of flesh by the circumcision of Christ, he is communicating an image of Christ doing spiritual surgery upon our hearts to remove the body of flesh from us.
保罗在这里谈到借着基督的割礼脱去肉体的时候，他传达的是基督叫我们心里，基督在我们的心里做了属灵的手术，已经除去这个属世的肉体。
This is a change from a heart of stone to a heart of flesh.
这是从铁石心肠到肉心的一个转变。
Scripture abounds with these metaphors to explain the sort of transformation or renewal of our inward nature that the Holy Spirit performs in us.
所以圣经中充满了这些比喻来解释圣灵在我们身上，进行了内在本质的一个更新。
Paul uses the language of flesh throughout his writings to talk about the corruption of our nature because of sin.
保罗在他整个的著作当中都使用肉体这个字眼来谈论我们因为罪而败坏的本性。
In Romans 7, he speaks about how the flesh is our sinful passions aroused by the law, and these bear fruit for death.
在罗马书第七章，他谈到，我们的肉体是如何因着律法，生出罪恶的情欲，来结出死亡的果子。
This flesh is both caused by sin and causes us to sin.
这肉体既是罪所造成的，也使我们来犯罪。
So when we see that Christ has removed this flesh, it is important to remember that this does not mean we automatically lose all desire to sin.
因此当我们看到基督为我们除去这个肉体的时候，并不意味着我们自动失去了所有犯罪的欲望。
But instead that Christ has struck a fatal blow at that root or habit of sin that dwells in us.
而是基督对我们内心的罪恶的根源给予了致命的打击。
Now, we are engaged in a constant struggle to continue to drive away those sinful habits which we had formed while we were, while also seeking to deepen spiritual virtues that the Spirit produces in us.
所以我们现在在进行一场不间断的斗争。一场属灵的征战，继续地赶走那些已经形成的罪恶的习惯，同时也寻求圣灵在我们里面产生的属灵的果子。
The fruits of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, and self-control.
也就是仁爱、喜乐、和平、忍耐、恩慈、良善、温柔和节制。
The death of our old flesh and the enlivening of the new is central to what baptism signifies for us.
所以肉体的死亡和新的身体的复活就是洗礼对我们最重要的核心意义。
When we consider our baptism and we accept what it signifies by faith, we are given a guarantee that as surely as we have been washed by the waters of that sacrament, so too have we been raised with Christ to everlasting life.
所以当我们考虑着凭着信心接受它所代表的意义的时候，我们就得到了这个保证，就像我们已经被圣礼的水洗净一样，我们肯定也会与基督一起复活并得到永生。
So when you struggle in this Christian life, when you fall into sin or doubt, I encourage you to consider the meaning of your baptism.
所以当你在基督徒的生活中有挣扎的时候，当你陷入罪恶的挣扎的时候，我鼓励你们来思考洗礼的意义。
Remember that God has put his name upon you.
记住上帝已经把你的名字把他名字放在你的身上。
And has promised that with it, he will save you.
并承诺他会拯救你。
Your baptism is a reminder of this fullness of confidence.
你的洗礼也提醒了我们会凭着信心与基督联合。
This confidence that is ours because of the union with Christ we enjoy by faith.
我们凭着信心与基督联合。
And the point of this passage here is that this truth does not hang on the doubtful speculations of men.
这段话的重点并不是说是依赖人类的怀疑的这个思想。
It does not rest on human philosophies or ideas.
也不依赖人类的哲学。
It is not something put together by generations of wise men living in monasteries and caves.
更不是说在修道院或深山里的修行。
Baptism was given to us by God.
洗礼是上帝所赐给的。
So to set it aside, to neglect faith in what it symbolizes,is to give up the only certain thing we can have.
因此说如果你把洗礼放在一边而忽略了它所给你的真实的意义就是放弃了我们能够拥有一个唯一能确定的东西。
This is Paul's burden as he contrasts what God has given to us through Christ and all that the world offers with its spirituality, philosophy, wisdom, and religion.
这是保罗在这里的负担，也就是他将神透过给基督的基督要给我们的东西与世界所能提供的一切，做对比，以及世界给我们的一切，就是还有灵性、哲学、智慧和宗教进行了一个对比。
The second practical benefit from this fullness of Christ, according to Paul, is the remission of sins that we find in Him.
所以根据保罗的说法，基督的丰盛带来第二个实际的好处是我们的罪孽得到赦免。
Paul is very clear that this new life is grounded in the fact that God has forgiven us all our trespasses, as he says in verse 13.
正如在十三节中所说的，上帝取消了我们的罪债，并将他们放在一边，钉在十字架上。
And then in verse 14, we read that God has accomplished this by canceling the record of debt that stood against us with its legal demands. This he set aside, nailing it to the cross.
正如十四节所说的，上帝将我们的罪取消了，并将他们钉在十字架上。
When we think back on this idea of being filled in Christ,we are reminded that before we can be filled by the life of Christ, we must have the sin which has filled our nature removed.
当我们回想起被上帝充满的这个想法的时候，我们就被提醒，我们被基督的生命充满之前，我们必须先除去充满我们本性的罪。
We have already looked at the removal of our corruption when we talked about the circumcision of our flesh, but here finally we come to the complete and full forgiveness of the sin that it caused.
所以当我们谈到肉体的割礼的时候，我们已经谈到我们人心中腐败的去除，最终得到对罪完全的赦免。
What Paul is saying here is very clear. Before receiving Christ, we stand guilty before God, having violated his law and owing a debt of eternal death, which we can never pay or overcome.
保罗在这里说得很清楚，在接受基督前，我们在神面前本来就已经犯了罪，违反了他的律法，所以欠下了永远无法偿还的这个永死的罪债。
But as Paul says elsewhere, while the wages of sin is death, the free gift of God is eternal life. Eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Okay, 但正如保罗在其他地方所说的，虽然罪的工价是死，但神的恩赐在基督里是永生的。
And this free gift is not given in a way that God violates his own justice. We should not think of God as just arbitrarily forgiving sins, or that the justice of God is somehow less than his love or his mercy.
这白白的恩赐并不是神违反自己的公义原则给予的。我们不应认为上帝只是随意的赦免，或在公义的某些角度下降低与他的爱与怜悯。
Instead, Christ is put forward as a propitiation for our sins. Propitiation meaning a satisfaction or atonement. This is the act of covering over our sins in a way that blots them out. And this is done, as Paul puts it, in Romans 3, in order that God might be both just and justifier of the one who has faith in Christ.
相反的，基督已经被提来为我们的罪孽作为挽回祭。意思是说他满足了这个赎罪的需要，这是一种以涂抹罪孽的方式来遮盖我们所犯罪的遮盖我们所犯的罪的一个行动。正如保罗在罗马书第三章二十六节所说的，使人知道自己为义，也称信耶稣的人为义。
For Paul, it is important that the debt we owe to God, that those wages of sin all be paid,so that the justice of God, as well as his mercy, might be maintained in full.
所以对保罗而言，最重要是我们欠了神的债，而那些的罪的工价都是必须要得到偿还的，这样神的公义和他的怜悯才能完全的维持。
And it is Christ alone that can accomplish this on our behalf.
所以只有基督才能代表我们来完成这件事。
This is why Christ entered into the world. We needed something more than a good example. We needed God to become man.
这也就是为什么基督要来到这个世界。我们需要的不只是一个好的榜样，我们需要是神成为人。
To bring life to our corrupted flesh and to take away the guilt of sin that excluded us from communion with him.
为我们的败坏的肉体带来生命。并除去使我们无法与上帝相交的阻拦。
Because Christ did this, we can now live in confidence, knowing that all our sins are paid for in full.
因为基督这样做了，所以我们现在可以坦然无惧的活着，并且直到我们所有的罪都已经被全额偿还。
We can rest assured that justice has been obtained.That our guilty verdict has already been passed 2,000 years ago.
因为已经得着了义，使我们可以得着这个，在得着的确据当中得到安息。我们的罪已在千年之前已经得到了判决，已经通过了判决了。
We don't have to live in fear of God when we sin, but now we can.Run to him as a merciful father to restore us, to correct us when we err and stray from this life.
所以当我们犯了罪的时候，我们不再活在恐惧当中，而是奔向这位仁慈的父亲。当我们今生犯了错和迷失的时候，他会医治我们并纠正我们。
And again, we can trust here that as surely as Christ has died for us, As surely as Christ has died for us, we know that every sin that we have committed has been dealt with.
Okay. 所以我们可以再次相信，正如基督已经死过一样，我们所犯的罪都已经被处理过了。
This is the hope of the Christian faith, that we are made right with God, not by our own doing, but by trusting in what Christ has done for us.
这是基督信仰里面的一个盼望。就是我们与神和好，不是靠着自己的行为，而是靠着相信基督为我们所做的一切。
This passage is beautifully summarized in the hymn, It is well with my soul, which says, My sin, oh, the bliss of this glorious thought, My sin, not in part, but the whole, is nailed to the cross, and I bear it no more. Praise the Lord, oh my soul.
有一段赞美诗《我灵得安息》这诗的歌词中看到一个最优美的总结，其中说到：“回想我的重罪，全钉在十字架上，没念此，衷心欢喜歌唱，主 主当我的重担，何其妙大恩情！赞美主，我心得到安宁。
And again, none of this is something that you could come to by abstract philosophy or merely human religious principles.
再次强调，这一切都不是你可以透过哲学或人类的宗教原则来得着的。
You may come up with the need for atonement, many religions in the world have.
很多的宗教体系可能都有一套自己的方法，让作为赎罪的这个，让你满足这个赎罪的需要。
You may even come up with some idea of how to get this atonement, whether through animal sacrifices like the pagan religions of old, some of which are still being practiced.
你可能会想出一些关于或如何获得这种赎罪的想法，像是透过古代宗教那种动物的祭祀，或者是一些精心设计的这个仪式。
Or you may come up with some elaborate series of rituals or harsh practices that are supposed to purge you of this guilt you have generated in this life.
所以你可能也会想出一些其他宗教仪式来消除你心中对于罪的这个罪恶感的恐惧。
But all of this merely rests on your best guess.
但这一切其实只是取决于你的这个一个猜测
，on your best intuition or your trust in the ideas or traditions of others，
就是取决于你对于这个传统的这些传统的宗教或者是传统的一些仪式的信任。
None of it has the guarantee of actually working，
但这些都不能给你真正的保证。
None of what the world and its religions can offer provides anything like the fullness of peace that this message of forgiveness of sins can offer.
没有一个世界的宗教可以提供，向你提供这种赦罪的信息所能提供的完全的平安。
God's favor is not arbitrary or unreliable. It is not obscure, so that we cannot know it in this life.
所以神的恩典不是随意或者是不可遥不可及的，也不是灰色难懂的，所以我们今生都没有办法看得到。
Instead, we have a firm foundation for knowing that all our sins have been washed away by the blood of Christ.
相反的，我们有一个扎实的这个基础，让我们所有知道我们所有的罪都已经可以解决了。
Of course, the story does not end with the death of Christ. We read in verse 15 that he, that is God the Father, disarmed the rulers and authorities and put them to open shame by triumphing over them in him.
当然这故事还没有，在这里还没有完全的结束。我们在第十五节中有读到，这个他即是父神。靠着他战胜了执政的掌权的，使他们蒙羞。
And him here, of course, refers to Christ.
这里的他当然就是指的是基督。
This brings us to the third and final practical point that Paul is trying to make with this section. One of the main reasons why we should not walk according to human traditions or the fundamental principles of this world is because God has disarmed these things and put them to open shame.He has utterly triumphed over them through the work of his son.
这为我们带来了保罗在这个部分中试图提出的第三个点，也是最后最实际的一个要点，就是我们不应该照着人类的传统或者这世界的基本原则行事。主要的原因之一是因为神已经解除了这些事物的武装，并且使这些事物被公开的羞辱。
It is not just that these things are less fulfilling or less satisfying than what we find in Christ.
这并不仅是说世界上的这些东西，比我们在基督里能找到的一切更令人不为满意。
But instead, that whatever they may have had to offer has been utterly abolished.
他们可能提供的一切都会被彻底的废除。
There is no use in putting our hope in kings, presidents. or governors, or no value in trusting philosophical speculations, no worth in whatever the spirit of this age has to offer.
所以我们不应该把我们的寄望寄托在国王、总统，或者是任何政府、政治人物的这个身上。这些都没有用的。相信哲学是没有价值的。这个时代的精神，除了能给我们带来的任何东西，都是没有价值的。这些东西都将会失去他们可能拥有的任何价值和力量。
These things have been made void of any value, any value that they might have had, any power that they might have possessed.
这些东西都会失去他们的价值和他们的拥有的力量。
Of course, until Christ returns, these powers don't look defeated.
当然了，在基督来到之前，这些力量看起来不完全是会被击败。
Every day we see and experience the evils of the fall, the pain of sickness and death.
我们每天还是会看到堕落与邪恶、罪恶与死亡和痛苦。
These things are still part of our lives.
这些还是我们生活周遭的一部分。
We may wonder, what certainty do we have that these things are true, given that our experience so often seems to be opposite to it?
所以我们可能会想知道说，遭遇我们的经验，我们常看到是相反的。那我们有什么把握可以确定这些事情是真实的呢？
First, we must consider that Paul is very clear that while the powers of this age are defeated by Christ, they are still in the process of passing away.
我们必须要看到保罗非常的清楚，说到时代的力量虽然已经被基督击败了，但是他仍处于在消逝的过程当中。
Just as when our hearts are renewed, there is not an instantaneous control over every sin or vice in our lives. In the same way, God has determined that the evils of this fallen world would pass away with time.
正如我们心里在更新的时候，我们生命中的罪恶或罪行都无法立即得到控制。 同样这个已经堕落的世界和邪恶会随着时间的流逝而消失。There
will come a time when this age finally ceases, when things will be set right definitively and absolutely. But until then, it comes gradually in steps.
所以终有一天这个时代最后会结束。 一切都将被彻底的、绝对的纠正，但是在那之前，一切都会逐步的到来。Sometimes
evil will seem to overrun the church. Sometimes we will face persecution. Sometimes prosperity. All while God is building His church.
所以，有时我们看到邪恶淹没的教会，我们会基督徒会面临迫害。 然后有时候也会有繁荣的时候，但是我们要相信神会一直建造他的教会。We
can be confident in this truth, not on the basis of what we see here and now, but on the basis that Christ has truly been raised from the dead.
我们可以对这个真理充满了信心，不是根据此时此刻我们所能看到的。As
surely as he has been raised, we know that the rulers and authorities of this age, both visible and invisible,
再一次正如他复活一样，我们知道这个时代的统治者和当局，不管是有形无形的。
Every force of evil in this world has been utterly defeated by death, by the death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord.
这个世上的每一个邪恶的势力，都已经被我们的主的死亡、埋葬和复活彻底击败。This
is not a blind trust. I'm not asking you to hope for something simply for the sake of hoping. Rather, we hope in what is certain, what cannot be changed, We open a tomb that was found empty and a Savior who has ascended into heaven.
这不是叫你们盲目的信，也不是说要求大家啊，为了希望而寄望什么，而是寄望那个已经确定无法改变的，是一个啊被找到的一个空坟墓和一位已经升天的主。
And so the practical implication for us,
对我们来讲实际的意义。
This victory that Christ has over the world means that we can live with a certain sense of peace, knowing as we deal with the hardships of this life.
基督对世界的胜利意味着我们当今在面对今生的苦难时可以感到平安。
If we experience personal suffering or tragedy, if we're struggling with fears about our future or the future of our family, if we're under the weight of seemingly endless anxiety, simply if we are feeling worn down by the troubles and cares,of this life, remember that the ultimate victory has already been obtained.
如果我们经历了个人的痛苦，我们再一次对自己的未来或家庭的未来感到恐惧当中，我们可以我们承受着看似无尽的焦虑与负担，简单的说，如果是我们因为所有的忧虑而感到疲惫不堪。
Be convinced with Paul that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers nor heights nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will ever separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. And this is certain because of his resurrection. He has put to shame every power that could ever conceivably separate us from the love of God in which we now stand.
所以当我们在面对这些苦难的时候，我们要相信保罗所说的，无论是死是生，是天使是掌权的，是有能的，是现在的事是将来的事，还是高处的是低处的，是别的受造物，都不能叫我们与神的爱隔绝。这是爱我们的主耶稣，就是在我们主耶稣的爱里。
Now you mayNow stop and wonder, what must I do to participate in this fullness which Christ is now offering to me?
所以我们现在可能你想知道，就是说我们必须做什么才能分享基督能为我们提供的丰盛。
How do you come to enjoy the fullness of life, the removal of guilt and shame?
你如何享受这个丰盛的生命，然后在没有罪恶和羞耻感当中。
How do you look to overcome the corruption of our flesh? How can you be triumphant over the powers of this world which are now fading?
你如何克服我们肉体中的腐败？你如何战胜这个已经在衰败的世界的力量？
The answer simply is that you come to it by faith in Christ.
答案很简单，就是透过你对基督信仰的实现。
Place your trust in him. Look away from what you have done or what you think you may be able to do. Your sin and good works are both to be traded for Christ, who will be your fullness.
把你的信放在基督的身上，把你的目光，在已做，就是从你已做过的事情或是能做的事情上移开，你的罪和善行都将被基督来取代。它将成为你生命中的丰盛。
For us who believe this today, this is a call to consider how we may let ourselves be led away by things that are not according to Christ.
所以对于我们今天相信这一点的人来说，这是一个呼吁，让我们来思考如何让自己不被那些不符合基督事物，不让这些不符合基督事物的事情来引导。
Have we allowed our philosophy of life, business, friends, or family to dictate the way we think or live? Have we been conforming ourselves to the ideals of this world, ideas of success and happiness that come from places other than Christ?
我们是否让我们的生活、事业或朋友或家人的思想或他们的哲学观念来取决我们的 来决定我们的生活方式，或者我们是否在让自己符合这个世界的理想，或来自基督以外的地方的这个想法。
Do we find ourselves seeking for advice from family, friends, coworkers, books, or the news instead of seeking help from Christ?
我们是否发现是否发现自己是从家人、朋友或同事或书籍或新闻当中得到生活上的建议，而不是来寻求基督？
Many of these things are good, but as Christians, we are being called to put them in their proper place.
这许多事情是好的，但是作为基督徒，我们要被要求将他们放在适当的位置上。
We are not to consume ourselves with beliefs or practices that God has not given to us.
我们不应该用上帝没有给我们的信仰或者是实践的方式来消耗我们自己。
Nor are we to require things of others which God has left to personal judgment.
也不应该向别人索取上帝留给人们的判断的这个智慧。
And so we must pray for contentment with Christ and His Word.
所以相反，我们要对基督和他的话语感到满足。
His Word, of course, is the main way by which we know God and know His will for us, and His will extends to all that we do.
他的话语当然是我们认识、了解神旨意的最佳的途径。
And so we should continue to train our hearts and minds by reading Scripture, attending to the means of grace, which are the Word and Sacrament, as well as prayer.
所以我们应该继续操练我们的心思意念，透过经文的阅透过经文，透过这个恩典的管道，也就是圣道和圣礼，以及祷告。
We ought to seek these things.So that God will shape us through them to be more and more like Christ.
所以我们应该寻求这些事情，好让神透过这些事情来塑造我们，使我们越来越像基督。
So that if we feel discontent with these things, if we feel somehow that they're lackluster or insufficient, remember that everything else has been made utterly worthless by Christ.
这就是为什么。这就是我们要如何认识并经历基督在这位用生命来充满我们的那一位。如果我们对这些事，我们对我们的生活感到不满的时候，如果这些事情，这些事情，感觉暗淡或不足，请记住，这一切都在基督里面变得毫无价值。
If Christ has been raised from the dead, there is nothing to go back to, nothing to return to that the world has to offer, except for the guilt and shame that is yours by right.
如果基督已经从死里复活，就没有什么可以回去了。除了你灵承担的内疚和羞耻以外，世界没有什么可以提供给你的。
The choice here is to continue in Christ, to abide in Him, to walk in Him, or to go back to the world.Which is in their share in defeat.
所以在这里的选择是你要选择基督还是选择这个世界，所和这个世界所能分享给你的败坏。
So now, as we go out to our week, let us remember who we belong to. Let us remember that we baptized Christians have life in Christ.
所以因此我们当我们新的一周开始的时候。请让我们记住我们自己是谁，让我们记住我们受洗，我们是受洗的基督徒，在基督里面拥有生命，而我们的罪也被赦免。
Remember that your sins have been forgiven, that you have been set free of all the powers of this age.
所以记住，请记住，我们的罪已经被赦免，我们已经被这个，我们自己已经被罪已经从罪中被释放出来。
Let us then walk boldly and seek after God in all that we do.
让我们勇敢地向前，在我们所做的一切事上来寻求上帝。
Let us learn day by day a greater sense of peace and contentment with these simple things which God has given us.
让我们日复一日地来学习，并被上帝给我们的这些事情上面享有更大的平安跟满足感。
So when we find these things hard or when we fall into sin, Let us be eager to return to these things as a sure knowledge that we belong to God and that Christ has truly come to save us to the uttermost.
所以当我们发现我们在经历苦艰难的事情的时候，或者是我们陷入最终的时候，让我们渴望回到基督的丰盛上面，并且确信我们是属于上帝，而在基督里而且确信基督确实已经来拯救我们到底。
Let us pray.
让我们一起祷告。
Almighty God, we thank you for this confidence in which we now stand.
全能的上帝，我们感谢你赐给我们信心。
We thank you for the sacrament of baptism.
我们感谢你赐下洗礼。
For the clear reminder it brings of our forgiveness of sins.
因为洗礼清楚地提醒我们罪得赦免。
The indwelling of the Spirit and the death of our old corrupted nature.
圣灵的内住以及我们的败坏的老我的死亡。
We ask, Father, that you would strengthen us by your word.
父神，求你用你的话语来坚固我们。
So that we might face this coming week with boldness.
所以我们可以勇敢地面对即将要来的一周。
Seeking after you in all we say and do.
在我们所做的事情上寻求你。
All to the glory of our King and Savior Jesus Christ.
愿一切的荣耀都归于我们的君王和我们的救主耶稣。
Amen.
Amen.